sign Rosenbridge, a wormhole. There is a person coming from the earth, going up this wormhole to the sun, you guys. This is so beautiful. Check it out.
Yeah, bras, send Victoria's in. Yo, yeah, bras. Yo, yeah, bras. Yo,
yeah. Look!
Yo!
You need to get the boy!
This shit.
Ain't no bear no more, y'all, you know? Look at the head shape.
Man, don't be touching me, holding me, because I'm finna run. Y'all, dial 911. Dial 911.
Welcome back to the coolest channel on YouTube. Yo, I got a special one for y'all here today. You know what I'm saying? Look, anytime I got the Harry Potter sweater on, look, you know. It's about to go down. Let's get this video to like 20,000 likes. Make sure you share with your friends and your family, man, because these videos, man, are interesting, say the least. You know what I'm saying? Make sure y'all go out here doing y'all fact check on your own. Don't believe nothing that you see on these videos. Always do your own research. And look, man, if you're having a bad day, just know we're going through this thing called life together, people. You know what I'm saying? You always got us. Dope community. Make sure y'all comment in the comments down below. Let's get it.
All right. I'm going to fuck y'all up with some shit on this one. All right. This is the Urbano Monte map from 1587. Excuse me. North Pole. No ice. No ice around any of these areas, okay? There's North America, South America, Africa, India, Russia, China. Okay, so very similar to this map. North America, South America, Africa, India, China, Russia. Okay? Only thing different, Australia. There is no Australia here because it hasn't been discovered yet. This is 1587. Australia wasn't discovered until 1606. So that's why that's not there. But my main question is, if this is a globe flattened out and this is on the bottom, right?
Mm-hmm.
What the fuck is this? There's no ice on it. And guess what? Antarctica hadn't been discovered yet. Antarctica was discovered in 1820. If you look, oh look, there's an alligator, there's a camel, warm weather animals. So, you want to explain to me, first thing, what the hell is this, all this land? And second thing, what froze them? What happened between 1587 and 1892? Where those areas got frozen.
What froze them, y'all? Let me know in the comments.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Me and JJ were out. We had gone deeper down the Amazon rabbit hole than like anyone had ever gone. We found this place, the floating forest, where you're walking on rafts of floating grass. And the anacondas love it.
Wow.
And JJ's going, this is anaconda. And I went, that is not anaconda. The grass was pushed down, but it was like, it was this big. Middle of the night, and we see two anacondas. One of them is so big that I would say it was probably 24, 25 feet. Gigantic. And my first response was, we have to catch this snake. And so I jumped on it. I just didn't think about it. And as I'm holding it, the one measurement I have is that I was holding onto the snake and my fingers couldn't touch it. That big.
Oh my that God. Big. Oh my God. Your fingers couldn't touch.
Yeah.
Dude, that's so big.
It's so fucking big.
Absolutely not. If you're my friend, you know better doing that. You jump on that, you by yourself. You out there, B. Like, I'm not that good of a friend. You feel me? Let me know in the comments down below how y'all feel about that. I'm not that good of a friend. It's over.
What's going on? I found a portal. And I saw Rosenbridge, a wormhole. There is a person coming from the earth, going up this wormhole to the sun, you guys. This is so beautiful. Check it out.
Yeah, bras, send Victoria's in. Yo, yeah, bras. Yo, yeah, bras. Yo, yeah. Yeah, bras. Aí, bras.
Of Aquarius, this is the age of knowing. So knowing these things are real, knowing that these things are possible, where do you guys think we're going to take the human species? We are going beyond, like Star Trek said, we are going beyond the knowing of what man has always known to be true. And it's going to be scary. It's going to be difficult for a lot of people to understand it, but this is real. This is so real, and I'm just happy to be alive at this time, right? It's an amazing time to be alive. So for all the people that call us crazy and we don't know what we're talking about and where did we get our education, baby, we came from the stars, and some of us came from the sun, and some of us will return to the sun. So buckle up, Buttercup. It's going to be an enjoyable ride for the human collective. I love you guys. Peace.
We have a late-breaking story coming out of Friendship, Indiana tonight. We have received eyewitness video from a source only identified as I'm the Cryptic. Several witnesses are reporting multiple unidentified flying objects flying above the Friendship flea market. The video shows multiple objects in an odd formation and seems to show at least one government recon aircraft in close proximity. We'll have more details as information continues to emerge from the area.
I got transferred to this room with this mirror. If there's no space, leave this place, right? Well, guess what else is fucking weird about this?
Employees only. Yeah, I know it's about to be a back room.
Ladies, make sure you pay attention to this. Fingertip doesn't actually touch. Fingertip touches. It's a bathroom. That's a mirror. Here's a closet. That's a two-way mirror. Here.
So yeah, I got transferred to this room.
Message, you know what I'm saying?
Just a quick one for the globe trolls. Yes, the ice wall goes down to the seafloor. Because the oceans need to be contained to maintain their level.
Antarctica is the ring around the Earth, so you know you can't fly over the ring and get anywhere. That's why we're not allowed to go there. I mean, think about it. It's the only treaty that's you know, all these countries have signed and never broken and completely agreed on. It's the only one. You know, what treaty is there that everybody's agreed on? We're being kept away from it for a reason. You know, they have some scientific bases there, yeah, and literally it's controlled by the military. If you try and go there by yourself, you will be sort of picked up and escorted back. There was a guy called Jarls Anderhoy who tried to take a mission to the Antarctica, and he was picked up and taken back by the military. It's a good reason because they don't want you finding out what's beyond. Admiral Byrd, he actually did four four expeditions.
Uh-huh. And Jupiter.
And most of them were military expeditions with huge military groups, you know, thousands of people, you know, planes, boats, the works. And yes, he confirmed in an interview that he discovered a land, a continent as big as the continental United States out there, that was with warm water lakes and mountains and everything, that was completely uninhabited. And he said, and he described it as the other side of the South Pole to Middle America. So on the globe, that means it would be somewhere in the Indian Ocean. There's a huge continent that nobody knows about. So there's more going on than meets the eye. The other thing is, after Admiral Byrd came back after his last expedition, Antarctica was sealed off, and both America and the Russians started firing nuclear missiles straight up. Now in America, that was called Project Operation Fishbowl, and it came under something called Project Dominic. Well, Fishbowl makes sense, because it seems like Admiral Byrd found the edge of the dome. Mm-hmm. Okay, while he was out there. And as soon as he left there, they started firing missiles straight up, I believe, to try and test how far that dome went. Mm-hmm. If you look at the footage of these explosions, what you'll see is an explosion. Well, when a bomb goes off in midair, it's a fireball. It expands in all directions and mostly up. Okay. Now, if you look at these explosions on Operation Fishbowl, they explode outwards in a ring, which means it's exploding against something because it can't rise with the heat. So it's just exploding against something and exploding outwards. Okay, in the middle of the explosion, you'll see it glows, you know, hot, and then it cools over time. So it looks to me like they were exploding against a dome. Now, I said it was Operation Fishbowl, obviously Fishbowl, but there's a chap called Rob Skiba who discovered that the Project Dominic, the word Dominic means of the Lord, Fishbowl of the Lord. So I believe they clearly know that we're in an enclosed system, and Admiral Byrd found the edge, and they've tested to see how far it goes up.
Thanks for watching. Like, comment, and follow at Mike Priest ARR for more content like this.
We're a pest species that's grown like a mold around the planet because our natural predator has been absent for a few hundred thousand years.
Wow.
10 times more intelligent than a human. It only needs a certain enzyme that humans have in their blood. And what it does is it basically goes into hibernation like a vampire. It lets the human population build up. And then when it comes out of hibernation, over a few generations, its existence may have been turned into myth or something, and then hunts the population down again, right?
Well, you know, that didn't sound good to me. You feel me, y'all? Like, that hit a little different, because, I mean, they've been having a whole bunch of movies about vampires and all these type of animals. Hey, what if an alternate reality is like some shit where you, you know, they got their bunker, rich people got their bunkers and stuff like that. That's why they going underground and stuff like that. And Eli and them trying to get out of space. Creatures come out the ground, bro, and start eating everybody. Like potato chips. We was just flavors up here the whole damn time, y'all. I know I said the one about them cracking the ceiling, and you know. But nah, this one is like we entrapped in here with some shit like that. That's crazy though, but I don't think that's gonna be it right there. Cause I think we can handle some vampires though. I ain't gonna hold you, but the fast zombies, I don't think we'd be able to come back from that one though. I ain't gonna hold y'all. Not the fast ones. The slow ones, yeah, we wouldn't even be an epidemic. We handle them. Let's be real. But the fast ones is over.
Sometimes people ask Alexa or Siri the strangest of questions and get the strangest of answers. This is exactly what Marina Barry did when she asked about the Antichrist. And this is what it answered. Pay very close attention and watch
Alexa,
till the end.
What is the Antichrist?
A noun, Antichrist, can have a few meanings. One, a particular personage or power, variously identified or explained, who is conceived of as appearing in the world as the principal antagonist of Christ. Two, an opponent of Christ, a person or power antagonistic to Christ. Three, a disbeliever in Christ. Four, a false Christ.
Alexa, is the Antichrist real?
This might answer your question. According to Wikipedia, in Christian eschatology, the Antichrist, or Antichrist, is a person prophesied by the Bible to oppose Christ and substitute himself in Christ's place before the second coming. The term is found 5 times in the New Testament, solely in the first and second epistle of John. The Antichrist is announced as the one who denies the Father and the Son.
Alexa, who is the Antichrist?
I'd rather not answer that.
Alexa, who is the Antichrist?
I'd rather not answer that.
Alexa, tell me, who is the Antichrist?
Sorry, I'm having trouble. Please try it in a little while.
Alexa, where is the Antichrist?
Wagner Lamounier has lived in Brazil and was born in Belo Horizonte, Minas Gerais, Brazil.
But damn, drop the dot on him.
This is the fourth time me trying to make this video. I don't know what's in the video that TikTok doesn't want you to know. Someone be very selective with the words I'm about to use. But I think you need to pay attention to this. That's all I'm gonna say.
Okay, so I just found some incredible news and I can't understand if this is really good news or really terrifying news. Let me know what you think. So the founder of AI is now going to pay people just for being human. The WorldCoin Digital ID Project has been launched. Okay, check this out. This is what they're doing. Apparently, just for being a human, you're going to get crypto and you're going to get paid, okay, from the AI founder. So you have to basically scan your eye with this futuristic orb and it stores your biometric data. Again, I don't know if this is amazing or terrifying, because it's trying to distinguish the fact if you're human or AI, and this is necessary, apparently. So, apparently, the project describes itself as a digital currency received simply for being human, claiming it could dramatically increase economic opportunity, scale, and reliable solution for distinguishing humans from AI. Apparently, this will be really important in the future. Despite these goals, WorldCoin token usage, blah, 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 blah. Apparently, check us out. This has not stopped major crypto exchanges from listing the token. Binance, OKX, Huobi, Bybit, Gate. Major platforms already taking WLD. So that's the guy that is the founder of ChatGPT and OpenAI, okay? And he's the guy that's behind this. So he's trying to give you money if you're a human. But here's the kicker. Where is it? Where does it say? WorldCoin users must physically travel to a location where an iris scanning orb is present in order to obtain the equivalent and global digital passport. The project's creators say this will become necessary to distinguish humans from AI bots as technology advances. So there you go.
In the future, the new oil will be data. Trying to incentivize you to get a retinal scan, huh? To just pay you to be human? Maybe it has a UBI connection. Because we know the advancing of artificial intelligence with robotics will be replacing jobs. But it's for the purpose of a digital passport, if you heard and paid attention. And to differentiate you from being AI or a human. Almost sounds like it has a little bit of correlation to a maybe social credit score, which is a ducks lining up in a row with all the technology, with policy, yeah, and the economy. And then BlackRock, the only outside entity ever to invest into a Chinese market company, invest into the only company that handles the artificial intelligence camera system social credit score program. Things are getting interesting. There's something else I want to say, but I believe that was the reason why they keep blocking this video. I don't know what was in my last presentation why they would not show the video, but this is the fourth time.
Wait a minute. You did work on the census, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's the season where y'all predicted Donald Trump and shit, right?
Don't believe those. It's just coincidence. You mean all those predictions, Donald Trump and aliens were gonna come? Nah, it was was just a
film, bro. Film.
It was a lucky guess. You know what was a lucky guess? Did you see the second Back to the Future movie?
I also saw it was a 9/11.
He's trying to deflect.
Did you see Back to the Future?
Well, it kind of seems like you're switching the topics.
He's what's his name? Fox. He's,
what about the 9/11?
No. They didn't predict anything about 9/11.
I've seen it, right? The Twin Towers, the Twin Towers beside it.
So how would you explain it?
Hold on a second. No, it was a coincidence.
Right hand up, it's just a coincidence.
Hey, James.
He didn't put his right hand up.
He's not even looking at us anymore. I think we're onto something. I don't know how much I can get out of him, but I'm going to try for y'all. The name of journalism. Wait, so don't you think
he's in charge of the whole convention. That guy. He's trying to be chummy with him. That's James Ponce. He's run a couple of conventions.
Well, you running a marathon around these goddamn questions, man. Like, it's crazy, bro. Shouldn't be this hard, man, if it was, if you didn't have something to hide. That's just the way I feel about this.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Don't you think it's kind of crazy how all these things come a reality? How would you explain it?
Well, it's scary. It's kind of scary that you hit it right on the nose without even trying, you know? Simpsons are, they're good at that. Did you see the movie?
Exciting news.
It's not just in Canada anymore. People are seeing this all over the world. Here's a map of the United States of sightings. What it looks like is it has a 25-foot wingspan, leather-like skin, and a noticeable tail. If you've seen anything like this, please leave it in the comments below. Thank you.
But damn, you know.
Look!
Yo!
You need to get the boy! Did the kids come out to look?
Yeah, how did that?
Did you see it? Thought when it was over here, it looked so crazy. It looked like it's on fire.
Yeah.
I don't think that's it. That sound comes from over there.
I think that was some type of launch or whatever, but you know what I'm saying? Look, it could be some blue beam action going on, but it looked like it was some type of launch. But y'all already know they're not going outside the firmament. They're going
is
down the street.
Is Antarctica a continent? Or is it an ice wall? Encompassing the level earth that we live on, containing the water. Because water always needs a container, it always lays level, dude.
Like, everybody knows this, right? Water on a lake, water in the sea, water in the pool, let's see, level at the top. It's all level, okay? And then you've got this, like, big problems, guys. No container and no level water on this curved, oblate, spheroid, ellipsoid, pear, whatever you guys believe it is. And by the way, this is CGI. This isn't a photograph. This is an image produced from a computer. Big difference, guys. Big difference.
But anyway, if you didn't know, we don't have a working flat Earth model because one, we're not allowed to go to the North Pole, and two, we're not allowed to go past the 60th south latitude right here. And you can see the maximum penalty down here in the red box. I know some of you guys are real thick. You really want a spoon fed to you. This is the Antarctic Treaty. The provisions of the present treaty shall apply to the area south of the 60th south latitude, including all ice shelves. Keep reading if you please. Also, is there a dome out there? The firmament? Dome? Valkyrie Dome? Dome Argus? Dome A? Dome C? No idea if there's a dome. Again, we're not allowed to go out there. But do you guys know who Captain Cook is? And you probably haven't heard about James Clark Ross, because the indoctrination camps we all went through, that we call public school, definitely didn't teach me about him. They circumnavigated the Antarctic Wall. It took them 3 to 4 years on a boat. And they tracked 60,000 miles. And again, this thing's supposed to only have a shoreline of 11 to 12,000. How did they manage to go 60? Why would they lie to us? Do you know how much resources could be out here? Oil, fish, food? Maybe they're not being ran by pedophiles? I don't know. NASA stands for Not a Space Agency. Just a bunch of gatekeepers, guys. Just a bunch of gatekeepers. And before you say, dude, you can go to Antarctica. You can pay to go there on a trip, man. $13,000 to do this. And look at this. This is where they're taking you. Go around Little Island. Look at it from the bigger picture, guys. But don't just blindly believe me. I'm just a guy on TikTok. You should definitely do your own research.
But yeah.
If you want more content like this, in my opinion, check out my link tree in my bio and make sure you're following me here. I got banned at 80,000 followers.
This reset will be a huge shock when Americans catch on. That's why the average person won't hear a word about the story until it's obvious to just about everyone. And by then, it's going to be too late.
Yep.
In the months ahead, central banks around the world are planning to go digital. Many of the legacy banks you've heard of, where you probably even keep your money, like Bank of America, Chase, Citi, Wells Fargo, they're about to be reset, overhauled by a new type of technology called fintech, which is short for financial technology.
Yeah, can I ask, what exactly does that mean for the banks and all of us, you and me?
Essentially, it means the function of our banks is about to change. They probably won't raise public suspicion about it by changing the signs on your bank's branches, but according to my sources, the Federal Reserve will soon own all the banks, and your local branch, it's simply going to be like a licensee of the Fed. In other words, the banking infrastructure is being rebuilt from the ground up, and very few Americans are aware this is even happening. We are right on the verge of a once-in-a-generation opportunity to profit by investing in the companies that are building out the architecture for this massive shift.
Hey, one thing, we're going to put y'all on game too, man, as far as like, you don't have to have, like, what's about to occur, you don't have to have a crazy amount of money to benefit from a collapse of a market and, the beginning of a new market. You know, just because everything crashes don't mean that you're SOL. You know, you just have to be prepared and in position and knowing of information. You know, the masses are more like, oh, it's going to, the market will crash and we're all going to be SOL. You know, like, ah, no. If you prepare and you feed yourself a little bit of knowledge and you stay calm about these things, you'll be prepared and you'll be in position to receive the benefits of what's to come. You know, but look, just be prepared. But it'll get into some more in this video, though. So make sure y'all really paying attention to that, though. Real talk. We need to get smarter, literally, about money.
Process of permanently closing its stores. Jeff Bezos, before the holiday, told people not to spend that much money. And then the first week of January, he let go of 18,000 employees. Now Macy's is gearing up for this. Yeah, you guessed it. Macy's had a Thanksgiving Day parade in the metaverse. They're gearing up for Web 3, 4, and 5. All of these companies, and shout out to K Crypto Insight on Instagram, have made it abundantly clear this is the route they are going. This is where they are heading. Will you listen? Or will you just turn a blind eye to it? It's on you, though.
actually out of the body when you're dreaming at night. So when you sleep for 7 or 8 hours, you're going to spend 3 hours. This is medical studies now. This is hard, no science now. Mm-hmm. We've known this since the 1950s when mm-hmm. we discovered the four brainwaves. You spend 3 hours out of the body into the fifth dimension. The question is, where do you go? Most people, because they don't know what they're doing, or because they're arguing with their wife, or they're worrying about problems, or because they had too many drugs, they go to the lower astral plane. Mm-hmm. That's a very bad neighborhood.
Like hell.
Well, except you can get out of it.
Okay. Yeah.
So it's like purgatory. Okay?
Purgatory, okay.
Whereas if you use the techniques I described, in psychic protection techniques and more positive things, you can leave through the crown chakra, not through the third chakra, which will take you to the lower astral. Mm. If you go to the crown chakra, which is where you want to go, now you go to the upper astral plane or the causal, mental, etheric, or even soul plane. Those are all positive dimensions. Okay. The only two negative dimensions are the lower astral plane and this one. We have a lot of problems here. But the other dimensions are all positive. And each dimension has a sound and certain characteristics that are relevant to it. For example, if you're out of the body and you hear the roar of the sea, you're on the astral plane. If you hear the tinkling of bells like a New Age bookstore, now you're on the causal plane where the Akashic Records are stored. If you hear the sound of running water, you're on the mental plane. And if you hear the buzzing of bees, you're on the etheric plane. Mm-hmm. Or if you hear the sound of a flute, you're on the soul plane.
Message.
We are not the same. I am a Martian. No, for real. Pleiadian starship. I travel to your sorry planet just to bargain. Your Earth is being foreclosed and put on the market. Your shit is over with. It was at the symposium at Cydonia in which we adjudicated, based on your illogical racism, pollution, and your brutal hatred, that will be the cause of your fumigation. Now you can choose the basic option of a huge invasion, or in few occasions, we allow for illumination, from which will result knowledge accumulation and multi-dimensional communication with your true creator. But you don't want that, so contact your puny nations. Go to war with nuclear weapons. Come on, it's human nature. My advice, choose illumination. Cause if you want beef, we'll be happy to treat you like our cow mutilations.
But damn. You know, the truth hurts, but
so
damn.
So a follower of mine messaged me with urgency about this disaster supply kit checklist. Her husband was sent this because he is of the military family and from the Northeast Pennsylvania area, close to Philadelphia. People in that area, if you're from the military, please, if you can confirm this, get back to me and see if there's others like you in the PA area. So please like, share, and comment so this video can get circulating. But we're going to talk about it. Hey, I'm Megan, and I follow you on TikTok. I'm going to blur her name because of anonymity, and I think she'll want me to do that. This is the checklist they sent us out of nowhere. Some people may say, oh, they send that randomly, but no, they fucking don't. My husband has been in 25 years and never has gotten anything like this. They also briefed them on where to meet if an outage happens. If an outage happens. That's all he really could tell me. He can't talk about his job with me a lot. He has top security clearance, but he's been stocking up on water, food, and bought a crank radio the other day. And that's very out of the ordinary for him. I feel something bad is coming, and I just want to try to stay prepared. Want to share so others can know. I don't think this is a drill this time. And I said, thank you, and under that, she says, I just want people to know. Now, her husband's been in the military with top secret clearance for 25 years. And look at this pause and zoom in and all that. But what I found extraordinary, was that they had a destination to meet in the case of an outage. Anybody who can speak, wives of the military, please send this to your military people that you know that are in the greater tri-state area and see if they've gotten something similar. That's New Jersey, New York, Pennsylvania, Maryland, Massachusetts, Connecticut. If anyone else can correlate what this woman has said, I would gladly like to have a conversation with them, because this is something that side bombastic side eye criminal offense side eye, huh? And her husband buying a crank radio, you know, that's interesting. She's been with them for 25 years. I would heed the warning. You guys should be blessed that she even said this to me. And to have you maybe start buying supplies. Nothing might happen, but something might. There's an old saying, you've heard me say it if you've been a follower. You'd rather have it and not need it than need it and not have it. You gotta stay blessed. Peace to the God.
Hey, that's a fact, though. Like, one thing that you do need to have, though, man, is your supplies, though. I understand that you got the list. I never got a list like that for me just to have at home and just in case of this. So, I don't know. But I'm not saying that they don't do that now. But one thing I can tell you is make sure y'all get y'all something that can charge your devices if it's not fried with a solar panel. Or, and now you can look online and you can put together your own contraption on how you can grab particles from the air and densify it and turn it back into water, the form of water that you can actually drink. You can actually make those yourself. You can actually get something to make that solar operated as well, just for a backup, and also a crank radio as well, you know, so you can know what's going on. You just got to have the basics and know how to survive anything. And that's what we don't need to lose touch with, be for real with you. We all need to be prepared for anything. Not to say, you know, we just need to be prepared for anything, you know, because your family depends on it, especially the men in the house. Get these supplies, man. I ain't got time to be sharing with everybody. I got mine to take care of.
A Mississippi Bigfoot. Tell me what y'all think in comments.
What? I see it too. That's probably why them dogs. Hold up. See it.
See it right there?
Yeah, I see it. Go get the gun. I'm talking about to get the gun.
No, you go get it. Let me keep it on camera.
Wait a minute. Hold up. I don't know what the fuck that is, man. It look like a damn bear. What is that?
I don't know, but it's moving, though.
Hell yeah, I wonder what is that, man. It look like a damn bear, man.
Man, look at it. See it move?
Yeah, I see it. I see it.
Well, go get
the gun. Hold up, man.
Get this stick, man.
Goddamn stick in my ass. Oh my God.
Yeah.
What is that?
Stick my ass. Pause.
I'm gonna get it on tape.
A bear or something?
Look like a damn bear.
Like it could be a bear.
Hold up. What the fuck is that? What is that?
What kind of car is that? What kind of car is that?
Go get the pistol. Go look under the seat and get the gun.
Yeah, yeah.
Look up under my seat.
What do you want?
Look up under the pickup seat. Get the pistol.
Come on, come on. It's in the truck.
Yeah. I don't know what the fuck that is, man.
I feel you.
Oh, my God.
He not leaning against the tree.
It's real, man.
He's just standing up. Oh, just standing up. I don't know if bear can do it that good.
Fuck? All right, bring the gun. Man, we're gonna be all over the news, man. What the fuck is that, man? Oh, I got all this on film. Ain't nobody gonna believe this. Oh my fucking God. Man, look at this shit.
Ain't no bear no more, y'all, you know. Look at the head shape.
Man, don't be touching me, hold on me, because I'm finna run. Y'all, dial 911. Dial 911.
He said call 911.
Oh God, what the fuck is this, man? Right by my house, man.
Look at the dexterity of the hands.
Oh my God.
Hey, I ain't got no bullets. Go get the bullets, man. Go get the bullets. Look, get the bullets. I ain't got no more bullets. Get the bullets, man. Hurry up. Look up on the seat, man. Get the goddamn bullets, man. Hurry up. I'm gonna shoot this motherfucker.
Yeah. Yeah, you one of those people that don't know he funny, but he funny.
Oh my God.
He dead serious too. Hey, look. Some people gonna be like, oh, that's just a conspiracy. Watch. People gonna invest, become wealthy, and everybody else gonna be sad as hell because they just so busy trying to tell people that they're stupid for, you know, doing research. It's a part of research you can find, like, you know, good investments.
That's how you find it. I keep thinking
news articles and everything, but some people don't get that deep into it, you know.
Think about Atlantis. Don't watch this video if you're not open-minded. A lot of people are saying we are in Atlantis, and this is the old world.
The civilization of Atlantis existed for thousands of years, and it was the entire world. It was not just an island out there.
Which makes sense because there are pyramids that are all over the world that align with the same star system. Giza, Mexico, China. I'm a strong believer that there are portals around this planet, and they knew how to use them to build these pyramids. That's why so many around the world. I'm pretty sure y'all saw this video.
Nobody go through it. Did you know that you could walk through the Grand Canyon? And if you keep walking through the Grand Canyon, your ass will end up in Africa, nigga.
There are Egyptian relics, hieroglyphics, artifacts, mummies in America because they were here. You ever wonder why it was so important for them to suppress this information for a century? Pyramids in Antarctica, Illinois. There are places in America that is restricted. The Hoover Dam. And we know the Grand Canyon and plenty of more spaces. The largest pyramid to ever be built is in America. The Atlanteans understood the energy of this planet and they knew how to manipulate it. Notice that there are weird levels of energy, like the Bermuda Triangle that makes things disappear. I told you they restrict off these high-level energetic places. I find it funny that one of the Egyptian gods has the head of an animal that's native to America. The Ibis. Rashad Jamal also goes to say that the 33rd parallel was the capital of Atlantis, which is in Atlanta, Georgia.
It's called Atlanta. It is on the 33rd parallel, which is one of the most powerful veins on the planet because this was the capital of our realm, Atlantis. Capital stretch, nigga. It was all of Georgia, all of Florida.
Can't stretch this enough, do your own research. I feel, though, that America is the old world. Now watch this. It is said that Atlantis went down in a flood. In America, it shows water erosion in the Grand Canyon.
We're underneath the water. That means that this place was underneath water. The Great Flood, the rocks are red. When the water oxygenates the sediments, they turn red.
Now I need you to watch this.
Whenever Atlantis went down, a lot of them, some of them went to Egypt, the survivors, and some of them went to Egypt.
I'm sorry, I just need to hear it one more time.
Some of them went to Egypt, the ones survivors, and to other places.
Y'all do what y'all want. I'm just connecting my thoughts. Notice how she says they went to Egypt, and they had powers to build such monuments.
Stone. This is where the pyramids and everything were developed later, were by the survivors of the Atlantis who still carried the knowledge of how this was done.
Put two and two together yourself, and y'all have a good day.
Just so you know, these blinds been closed. Stay dangerous, y'all. Now that you over here on YouTube, I find it very funny that there are people that are claiming they're the descendants of ancient Egyptians.
This is what the ancient Egyptians actually look like. Dark-skinned, olive-toned, like myself.
So, hey, if the Atlanteans was the descendants of the pyramid builders, y'all stay dangerous.
You ain't gotta explain no more.
So you guys wanna know why they're just now disclosing aliens and why they've been trying to deny it all this time? Because once you get into the aliens, you start getting into the grays, and the grays are humans from the future. It's what we end up becoming because of technology, because of these vaccines, just because we've disconnected so much from our own true essence. You can already see it start to begin with people and children. You know, it gets into a whole lot, but once they admit the aliens are here, then they're going to have to admit about this being a holographic matrix, and then they're going to have to admit the truth about the kingdom, and then they're going to have to admit the truth about this being a spiritual war for your soul, and the human body is the vessel that's carrying your spirit and soul to either eternity, or do you just get rebirth in the matrix so that way you can heal your soul wounds and ascend into the next solar system, Andromeda, and live a better existence with God. Everything's hidden and symbolic, but only if you have the eyes and the ears to see and hear. This is why the biggest scheme is healthcare. Healthy is heal thy. It's heal thyself.
Yo, imagine being that famous where, bro, like, you can't go nowhere, bro. Like, you literally get in the back of your head recorded, hey, the tattoo ain't back there. Hey, the scar from his surgery, his hair transplant ain't back there. You feel me? But, hey, on another note, though, is that Jamie or is it not? How y'all feeling in the comments down below?
Are you guys seeing these hurricanes in all of the oceans? Like, the ones that are hitting the U.S. are huge, but the ones that are coming for, like, Africa and other places are tremendously huge. Like, what is going on? You guys go look at this stuff yourself. This is craziness. I don't even know what to say, but prepare for everything. Prepare right now and raise your frequency to the highest high. Be a match for this new earth, man. Not this timeline. We're going to be hit on both sides. Where do we go? The middle? I don't know, man. Colorado, raise high and go deep. I mean, I don't know. Where's the answer in this? I'm going to try looking around and seeing more, but this needs to get out there, you guys. The hurricanes are humongous. They're coming in everywhere. Not just the U.S. There's even bigger ones that are hitting other places, you guys.
And that's what I'm talking about, too, because look, I remember the other video I posted, yesterday, somebody was like, oh, the weather stuff, you know, saw with somebody in the comments, oh, the weather stuff is so draining, and didn't do the, look, all that I'm communicating with that video is basically, look at the weather changing, These things have never happened before, and now they're happening. And if they, you know, rare events, now they're happening more frequently. Like, it's just too much going on at once, you know, to keep up with. But it's damn interesting. Just look at the storms combining and everything. That's like, it's not even at the height of, hurricane season and stuff like that. Imagine how it's going to get, man. Woo! I would hate to be living on the coast, though. I would hate to be living on the coast, man. I would get ghosts, be for real with you. Because that's just too high risk, man. Especially like Florida and all those other places where they got gators and stuff. Yeah, I'm still on the gate. Look, man. And then the people, it'd be flooded and they'd be walking through the water and stuff. It's a different type of people out there. And I don't even know if I'm cut out from that cloth, bro. Like, I ain't even going to hold you, man. You have to come get me with a helicopter or something. But look. So I just want to avoid that at all costs, man. But look, hopefully everybody's out here being safe, man. Make sure you do your own research. Don't believe everything you see on the internet, man. Make sure you're sharing these videos with your friends and your family. Yo, all the homies out there, make sure y'all get y'all family defense package, you know. Be prepared for anything, you know. We don't know what's to behold us in the future. So all we can do is prepare and, you know what I'm saying, keep our vibrations up, keep our spirits up, keep our souls up, you know, keep our vibrations high and keep changing with this world that we're in, you know, in the best positive way that we possibly can, man, so we can be, you know, the best galactic citizens, you know, we can possibly be. But look, man, I love y'all. I see y'all in the next video. And like I always say, spread love because there's too much hate in this world. Love you guys. See y'all next video. And I'm out, though. Bye.